Get ready to match the stars from Chips, Robert Pine, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, WKRP in Cincinnati, Lonnie Anderson, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and Patty North, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn!
Thank you, friends, for joining us here on Match Game PM. You're going to have a wonderful time because we all have all these wonderful people. Now, would you say hello to our two players here, Eleanor Gordon and Ron Carr? Applause, applause, applause. Oh, boy. Hi, you two. And you, sir. And before we begin, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. Anything you care to tell us will be welcome. Ron Carr, we'll begin with you.
Well, I'm an unemployed bachelor from Aurora, Colorado, which is a suburb of Denver.
Yeah.
And my biggest hobby is the history of the fur trade era of the United States, along with American Indian history.
History of the fur trade?
Yes.
So you know about the mountain men and all that?
Yes, sir. As a matter of fact, some of my friends have movie parts.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, that's a fascinating history.
It is very
part of American history.
Yes,
and we congratulate you for that work. Good luck to you here. Eleanor, let's find out about you.
Well, I'm a secretary, and I have a daughter that's 3 years old, and that's about it.
That's about it.
Yes.
Nothing else you want to tell us?
I'm happy that I'm here.
Well, we're happy to have you here, Eleanor. Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of the beautiful people as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $20,000. Get ready for that. Here we go. Ron, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. We're off and running. Here it is. Sheila always has to know what time it is. When she's at the beach, she uses her husband's blank as a sundial. Okay, here we go, Ron. Sheila always has to know what time it is. And when she's at the beach, she uses her husband's blank as a sundial.
His nose.
His nose. Very good. Okay, one good possibility. What do you say to that, Robert Pine?
I say I'm wrong.
You didn't match?
Stomach.
His stomach. How would you use that as a sundial? You'd have to hammer a nail in it or something like that? Stick a broomstick in his navel, and then that would give you the... Okay. I saved you, didn't I, Robert?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Hello, darling.
Hello.
Nobody is more shocked than I am. Nose.
Nose it is. One for him.
Finger. I'm sorry.
Finger is another good possibility.
Yeah.
Yes. Nose and finger were the two good choices there. Or if there were, he had a protuberant toe, that would also be interesting.
Interesting. Yes. Yeah, except that I said nose.
You said nose. What do you say, Bob Barker?
I say the actual retail... No, that's another... No. It's the same studio. My mind is wandering. I said no.
Nose it is. Don't expect to, you know, you can't have everything, Ron. Hello, Patty.
Oh, hi, how's it going?
Good, how's nice little Max?
He's there? Just fine, thank you. And how's little Lynn?
Well, wonderful, thank
good,
you.
Good, I'm glad to hear that.
Yes.
My turn?
Yes.
Patty and Jean, this is your life.
I said she uses his ex-girlfriend.
His ex-girlfriend. Just buries her halfway in the sand, draws a big circle around her.
Head first, feet up.
Head first, feet up. Right. Wonderful. Okay, three for him, Eleanor. Let's see what we have for you. One little goodie here of equal difficulty. Lois Lane said...
Oh, boy.
She said, let me tell you about Superman, the man of steel. After a few hours with me, he becomes the man of blank.
One moment. I'm totally uninspired.
Really?
Yes. It's the first
when
time it's ever happened in all my life.
Help him.
Gene.
All right. What?
I'm inspired now, but it has nothing to do with the game we're playing.
That's hot.
No.
Gene. Write your answer down.
No. You are the host. You are in charge. Ask her to whisper something to me again. Just anything.
All right.
Just whisper something. Just keep whispering. All right.
He's got one.
That's a good game we were playing.
Lois Lane said, now, let me tell you about Superman, the Man of Steel. Well, after a few hours with me, he becomes the Man of Blank.
My mind was blank, but I thought of gold.
Gold? I don't think you quite got the idea here, Eleanor. Man of Steel, one would tend to say something in the opposite direction of steel,
yes,
right? Like such as...
I was right on there.
Such as rubber.
Rubber.
Yeah.
Yes.
You become very loose and pliable. That's one possibility.
Yes.
First you take a pound of butter.
Pound of butter. Another very soft material.
I missed that movie.
Yeah.
Hottie!
Hottie! Now you got the idea, haven't you, Eleanor?
Yes.
Man, a putty just became putty in her hands.
Putty or jello.
Jello is another good possibility. Anything you say is okay with me.
After she had whispered in my ear, I...
Naturally, you couldn't think of an answer.
I said mud.
Yes.
Mud.
Yeah. Your name is Mud,
and
too.
To this audience, I say mud in your eye.
Yeah. Does Dorothy Jo watch television?
She did until tonight. No, I must tell you, the last time I was with you, she said that she couldn't stand to watch because she's embarrassed with my answers. And after
your
that
answers
one...
have been good.
And knowing that she's not watching, whisper in my ear one more time.
All right, Miss Patty Deutsch, we're up to you.
Tonight, your answers are going to look good.
Thank you.
40% cotton, 60% polyester.
Wonderful. Okay, so there we have you in round one. 3-0 is the score. Round two coming up, but first thing. Okay, here we go. We'll go to round two. I'll push a button around your head. We'll ask you to go first.
I'd like B again, please.
B it is. Three people play. Robert, Charles, and Patty.
Thank you.
For you especially. This. Janet said, my husband gets mad if I wear anything sexy and revealing. So I told him, just because you own the tree doesn't mean the other guys can't look at the blank. Ready, Ron? Good talk?
No.
Janet said, my husband gets mad if I wear anything sexy and revealing. So I told him, just because you own the tree doesn't mean the other guys can't look at the blank.
Limbs.
At the limbs. Okay. All right. What do you say?
I didn't say that.
You didn't say that?
No, Mark.
At the bark? Just because you own the tree, the other guys can't look at the blank.
For nighttime.
Right. She didn't see me in the daytime.
We've got to get somebody else for this nighttime shot here.
Okay, Jack.
She gets so giddy when anyone is handsome and young next to her. Look how giddy. She's sad. You get a stick and hit her. She won't even know you're doing it.
I'll just throw a bucket of cold water at her.
I think it's a match. Branches.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Betty Deutsch.
It's not quite the same play on words, though, is it?
Limbs and branches?
Yeah, well, you know.
Just because you own the tree doesn't mean the other guys can't look at the...
Limbs.
Limbs.
Nice.
Look on her.
Well, you would have said limbs if you were playing, right, Bob?
I wrote limbs.
You wrote limbs.
But Lonnie, and particularly coming from Lonnie.
No, it's not allowed. No.
It's not allowed?
Well, it was perfectly... was not. Now people are going to think I have a pornographic mind. Yeah. She had a very funny answer.
You kids just like...
You're going to leave it hanging there like
well,
that?
Well, I was going
to... I wouldn't do this to you on your show, Bob.
Well,
I think that's rotten of you to do that to us.
Gene.
You get us halfway to the punchline there, and you drop it out. Okay, Bob.
All right.
All right,
should
Bob,
I tell
that's
him?
Way you feel should about I? It. All right.
Well, this lovely... Do you mind if I talk?
No, go right.
May I go ahead? This lovely girl, read the question again.
Just because you own the tree doesn't mean the other guys can't look at the...
Apples. Coming from her, that's cute.
Or cantaloupes, depending on. Now, Eleanor, this one is yours. Skinny Minnie is so skinny. She uses a rubber band for a blank.
Darling, it's been 6 long years.
Oh, Eleanor. Skinny Minnie is so skinny. She uses a rubber band for a blank.
For a belt.
A belt. Okay. Tiny waist. Very tiny waist.
Yes. Eleanor, thank you. I've redeemed myself.
A belt. Wonder, Eleanor?
I thought not only was she skinny, she was a little teensy-weensy person, too. I equate skinny and little with the same. I said girdle.
Girdle. Okay. We're looking for a belt.
A friend of mine uses a headband for one of these, so I said bra.
A bra. But that would not
and
be
she's very
your friend
skinny.
Down here. Hello, Lonnie.
Hello.
She uses a rubber band for a...
Well, I thought if she was that skinny, she'd use a rubber band for
a bra.
For a bra,
yeah.
We're back to apples again.
Okay.
I said belt.
Belt. That's cool. Would you like to give the lady a little belt?
I'd like to have one.
I'll settle down. Belt.
All right, she won. 5-3 the score. Here we go, the third and final round. Ron, you're still ahead. We'll ask you to go first again.
I'd like A this time, please.
You want A? Okay. Harry said, I love my new apartment with the mirrors on the ceiling. The only problem is, yesterday I fell off the chandelier while I was blanking.
Glad I'm out.
You play. Only one person. You.
Only
you.
One person.
You.
You. Read that again.
Ah, you read it yourself. I'm tired of reading these things.
I love my apartment with the mirrors in the ceiling. Only problem is yesterday, I fell off the chandelier while I was...
Honey, this is going to take time. Whisper in my ear one more time.
Ready? Harry said, I love my new apartment with the mirrors on the ceiling. Only problem is yesterday I fell off the chandelier while I was blanking.
What you always do in a mirror department? Swing. What? Swinging.
Swinging.
Yes.
That's what you always do in a mirror department. Swinging. All right. You understand the intent of his answer, Judge? Yes, you do.
Okay,
Ron. Robert Pine.
Shining them, Ron.
Shining the mirrors. You people thought he was going to say something else because you thought he was one of the swinging members of the Hollywood community, the land of Sodom and Gomorrah, of sophistication, all that. Well, you're just wrong, America. This is a very small town. Okay, where are we? Are you ready, Eleanor?
Yes.
Now, here's what you have to do. You
what
have
did
to have
you say?
2 to tie and 3 to win, okay? Who plays? Brett
I
plays.
Play.
Charles plays. And you play, Lonnie. Here's a little match game riddle for you. How can you tell that King Kong is in your room? Answer, you can smell blank on his breath. Here we go. A match game riddle for you, Eleanor. How can you tell that King Kong is in your room? The answer, you can smell blank on his breath.
Bananas.
Bananas, that's cool. That's his main, his main diet, the main staple of his diet, right?
Who was he crazy about? Who was he so in love with he couldn't see straight? Who did he want to marry? Who did he want to spend his life with? Faye Ray.
Oh, really? Oh.
Boy, what natural, simple acting.
You must match you. Everyone else now
bananas,
to stay in the game.
Honey.
Bananas. 5-4 the score. All right. Now, if you match this lady, we'll have a tie game. Here we go.
That's terrible. I'm so sorry. I said Faye Ray.
Faye Ray, so that means Ron Carr wins the game. There you go. That's a little good job there. Eleanor, it was a pleasure to meet you. We'll send some gifts your way and our thanks for being on Match Game PM. Eleanor Gordon, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
While we're spinning her off, we've got a message or two just for you. Here we go, Ron Carr. Time for the big money where you can win over $20,000. To do that, we have two audience matches for you. Here we go with the first one. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Collins. $500 for matching their most popular answer. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And then for matching the third, $100. Three of the six stars will assist you.
I'll give Brett first chance.
Something I think is nice in the summertime, a friend of mine, Tom Collins.
Tom Collins. One.
Carl.
Dorothy Collins.
Dorothy Collins.
Catch up.
Bob.
Joan Collins.
Joan Collins. So you have Joan Collins, Tom Collins, and Dorothy Collins. At this point, you have the option of electing one of those or choosing one of your own.
My first thought was Tom Collins.
Tom Collins. Let's see if it's up there and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Joan Collins. Let's see if we get a Tom Collins under the $250 number. Judy Collins. Last, another singer, yeah. Last chance for Tom. Here we go. You got him. Atta boy. Okay, you've won $500, which means at least you'll be playing for 10 times that amount. Or $5,000. That's the least you can play for, but you can gain more here with our second audience match. All right. Flint blank. Flint blank.
Charles?
Flintstone.
Patty?
Michigan.
Flint, Michigan.
There's another one?
Place.
I don't know.
And Robert?
Oh. What's wrong, Robert?
Yeah, isn't that terrific?
Gee, well,
very small town that... Aha!
Just got an idea.
What got me through school?
What?
Large eyes. Flintlock.
Flintlock.
Yeah.
So those are the three they've given you. Flintlock, Flintstone, and Flint, Michigan. Which one do you want? Or do you want one of your own?
My first impression was Flintstones.
Yeah! Flintstones. That's what Charles gave you. Well, we'll go over there and reveal the $100 number. Flint, Michigan, and you laughed at that sweet little natural redhead. All right. We are looking for the Flintstones. Let's see if they're hiding under the $250 number. Flintlock.
Hey,
nice going,
yeah,
Robert.
Well,
Pine.
Know, I knew that all along.
Stand up and take a bow. Right, okay. Stand up. You must learn how to bow if you're going to stay
I know,
in the business.
I can't
business.
Get out of here.
Oh,
they
I
have
see.
Me trapped. They have me locked here.
All right. Now, Ron is looking for the Flintstones. Let's see if it's under the big one. Go. Yeah. Ron, you've won another $500. Multiplied by 10 makes another $5,000. We add that to the previous $5,000 you won, which means the least you'll be playing for is $10,000. But you can double that stake if you'll step into my office here and give the wheel a spin. And if it comes it blue there, we hope we get the double, right? All right. Which star will it be, and will it be a double? Looking good here. Not quite, but $10,000 is still a formidable sum of money for you, sir. Good luck to you. You ready, Charles?
Good luck, everybody.
Cheaper. Here we go. Blank broker or blank broker. Give you both inflections here. Blank broker. All right. Now, Ron, if you give us the answer that Charles has written on the card, we give you $10,000. What do you say to that?
Stock broker.
Stock broker. Charles, he says stock broker will match you for the $10,000. Charles, don't do that to us.
Is it tense enough?
Stock!
Stock!
to you and while you're celebrating and your family out there, we're going to do a little message for America.
Well, Ron, now that you've won a total of $11,000, you do promise that you're going to watch Lonnie Anderson on her TV show, WKRP Cincinnati, right? On CBS, yes. And you're going to watch Robert Pine on Chips, right?
Yep.
And you're going to watch, what's his name here on The Price is Right? Yeah. And you will continue to watch everybody else here on The Match. Yes.
He's just won $11,000?
Right.
I have some land. The price is right.
That's enough. Cut. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye. Ciao.